247zero is a record-breaking printer based on Voron Zero. And now you can build it. Step files, STL files, and more is uploaded to our GitHub for you to use. For free, open source, and as convenient as possible. Just as we all like it. Right now at 247 Printing. Today's video is sponsored by PCBWay. Check out the link below to learn more about their services and about exciting design contests they are hosting now. On my GitHub page, you find two branches for 247zero, one for the beta 1 files and one for the beta 2, about which we talk about today. Though not everything you'll find will be at a 100% complete state at the time releasing this video, you should consider everything you download from there as work in progress. Though the step file and the full CAD model, STLs and the BOM are at a reasonable state from my point of view. All provided STL files are positioned correctly for printing and have been tested for printing. I hope we'll have a proper manual at some point, but for now the step file and CAD model is your guide for building 247zeroBETA2. Use a CAD program like Fusion 360 to open the step file. I tried to make it as complete as possible, meaning you find all the parts and assemblies which are designed and tested on 247zeroBETA2, including all the fasteners needed for the build. You'll also find an extras, options and experimental assembly, which is not part of the main build, but it contains designs and assemblies are made for testing various stuff. I recommend to hide that assembly, clicking on the eye to not get confused at the start. 247zero is based on Voron 0.2, so I also included the base assembly of the parts needed from the default printer in the step file to make it complete. If you plan to build 247zeroBETA2, you either strip down your old existing Voron 0, or you source and build up a Voron 0.2 to that state to proceed with the beta 2 upgrades. What you roughly need is the frame, the XY motors, linear rails, and your choice of bed assembly. The sturdy and heavy Feistec one, which I tested a while, made a good impression. Use the Voron 0.2 assembly in the step file, the official Voron BOM, as well as the official build manual to build that basis. The drag chain for the Z-axis should already be attached. You insert the modified deck panel for the 24/7 ESPC2 cooling system and the modified mid panel, which can be used to get all the braces onto the frame. The bottom panel depends on the mainboard used. We'll get to that later. Next to STL files, my GitHub also provides DXF files for the panels, to be used with a freaking laser cutter, for example. Xtool thankfully sent me their P250W CO2 laser cutter along with some accessories for supporting my projects. That allowed me to test my DXF files for the panels for laser cutting. Getting ready with software and machine worked well for me as a total beginner, and it seemed safe for operation without laser goggles. Aligning the contours of the DXF files with the P2 camera support and getting the machine started with those presets is a neat and straightforward process. Though acquiring a laser cutter for making Voron 0 panels only is probably overdone. Alternatively, just let those panels be manufactured, or if you have a printer larger than 230 mm² the build area, just print the panels from PETG. Now, after you inserted the mid panel and the back panel, also check where to load additional M3 nuts to go on with the build. All of them can be found in the CAD model. These LDO nuts here proved to be super handy to be inserted afterwards if you forgot to load certain M3 nuts. In the electronic section of the CAD model, you'll realize that using a Big TreeTech Octopus Pro mainboard is the main path for the build. I started with and tested the Big TreeTech E3 Easy, which results in a less complex package and therefore still is a viable option, but it has limitations. The MCU is, let's say, not the fastest on the market. Therefore, most of the stuff I showed on 247zeroBETA2 would not have been possible with the E3 Easy. The Octopus Pro is just more future-proof for that build. It has an MCU fast enough for speeds at or way beyond 1500 mm². It allows to add more temperature sensors, for example for monitoring the motor temperatures, and four-wheel drive will be feasible as it allows to add additional stepper drivers. To enable the package of the Octopus Pro, you need to use the set drive from Voron 0.0, which also allows you to use a stronger NEMA 14 motor for the set movement, which is good for cutting off some seconds in crazy speedboat mode. The bill of material includes the parts needed for that. The assembly is shown on the Voron 0.0 build manual, which can be found in the corresponding branch at Voron Design's GitHub. If you don't chase the absolute maximum speeds, the E3 Easy will be okay for you, and you will find all depending and necessary designs in the Extras Options Experimental folder or assembly. My recommendation concerning the X beam is to use the mellow carbon fiber beam. You'll find the link in the bottom. In my video about lightweight X beams for Voron Zero, I also tested a do-it-yourself carbon fiber beam and my ultra lightweight aluminium hyper beam. All files needed for building or manufacturing these are also published on the 247zero repository. You could machine the hyper beam by yourself, or it can be manufactured quickly and conveniently using the services of PCBWay, the sponsor of today's video. And therefore, heads up, PCBWay hosts two design contests right now. The 10th Batch Design Contest invites designers, creators and visionaries to exhibit their enthusiasm and skills for design. Win prizes up to $1,000 in this challenge. Submit your creative ideas until June 15th, 2024. The second competition, the KiCad Open Source Design Contest, invites beginners and experienced engineers to participate in communication and automation themed design challenges. Submit your designs by June 2nd for this one to win money and other interesting awards like Raspberry Pi 5 and other goods. Thanks a lot to PCBWay for hosting these contests and for sponsoring this video. The part cooling for 247zeroBETA2 again is a specialty. I use a new variant of the 247 external static pointed cooling system, which I established in 2021 on a Voron 0.0. Explained quickly for new viewers, there are no fans carried on the toolhead to save weight on the moved masses. We use powerful frame-mounted server fans and air ducts guiding the airstream to nozzle and surroundings. Works very well in this setup. My toolhead design is an ultra-lightweight derivation of the original Voron 0.0 Bowden toolhead. At the time speaking, it supports mosquito volcano style hot ends only, which is a heritage of the early days. I am not happy about that state, and that's where I ask you for help. Getting everything ready for publishing was way higher efforts than anticipated. Complexity more than quadrupled from beta 1 to beta 2. I would have liked to have proper manuals, wiring diagrams, more toolhead and extruder options. That was simply not possible to provide for today's video, which was actually delayed for 2 weeks in order to get everything ready on the GitHub. You can help and support me by contributing in various ways. I never asked for that officially before, because I was a bit shy to do so, but consider supporting me and my work on Patreon. My dream is to do 24/7 printing full-time someday, to go deeper into more printer projects and to be able to post more videos more frequently. This won't work without Patreon supporters on my side. Also consider contributing designs, manuals or wiring diagrams. Beta 2 won't be the end, that's for sure. Join the 24/7 printing Discord to ask for help, to discuss your ideas or for just hanging out and chat, you're very welcome to join. If you like 247zero and this video, please show some love, like, share this video and subscribe for more. Servus and bye bye. Standing ovations for our Patreon Gold supporters, Eric Chung and Wayne Conrad.